Five on your health tonight. So listen to this here. New concerns about fluoride in drinking water. Researchers now say very high levels are linked to lower IQs in kids. Here to explain is Dr. Scott Hadland, Chief of Adolescent Medicine at Mass General for Children. Good to see you, Dr. Hadland.
Good to see you too.
All right, Dr. Hadland, we expect to see fluoride at the dentist's office, but let's back up a little bit. Why don't you explain why it is found in drinking water in some communities?
Right, fluoride in drinking water is actually one of our major public health successes of the last 80 years. It's been in our municipal drinking water across America since about the 1940s. And what it does is it prevents cavities. In fact, it reduces the risk of cavities by about 25%. That's a really big deal. If you think about sort of the return on an investment for something like this, for every dollar that a community spends putting fluoride in the water, they actually save about $20 in cavities that, you know, don't happen because of this protective effect.
Okay, so this new study, right, suggests fluoride may affect brain development in children. So what can you tell us about this link?
Right. So this study was done because, you know, we have to ask the question, could there be too much of a good thing, right? Could there be downsides to this fluoride? And actually, we've got a few decades of research that have had mixed findings. Some studies showing that perhaps fluoride in water might be linked to lower IQ in kids. Other studies showing that, you know, that may not be the case. And so what the National Institutes of Health did here in the United States is that they commissioned what's called a meta-analysis. That's a fancy word for they took all of the studies that have been done that were of any reasonable quality, pooled them together, and then found out what it showed when you brought all these results together. So they brought together 72 studies and did find this link whereby higher levels of fluoride in drinking water were linked to lower IQs in kids. But I have to put two huge caveats on this. First of all, the levels of fluoride that need to be present in water to cause or to be linked to that kind of decrease in IQ are about 1.5. It's actually milligrams per liter. That part's not important, but just sort of think of 1.5. The levels of fluoride that we have in our drinking water across the United States are actually less than half that, 0.7. So we're not in the range of these higher levels of fluoride that should be concerning. And then the second thing I'll say is that the link was actually only associated with sort of 1 or 2 points in IQ, which is really quite small when you think about the fact that average IQ is about 100. And so 1 or 2 points out of 100 in a situation that doesn't even happen here in the United States very commonly is not something to worry too much about.
Yeah, a lot of these studies were from overseas. All right, Dr. Scott Hadland, thanks so much for your time. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Hadley.
And to our viewers, if you have questions that you would like our experts to answer, you can email them to ask@wcvb.com.